Good morning, good morning. Well, I told them I was going to be there at 10, and then I thought, well, 3 hours might be a little too early. So I figured I'll get there about 11. Just did my pre-trip, just waiting until my 15 minutes are up. Should get there about 11, 11.05. Said that the broker said they weren't busy today, so it shouldn't be any problem. Loading me real quick means I should be, if all goes well and there's no problems, I should get there at probably 3, 3:30, and then I don't deliver till tomorrow at 11, which I'll get there at 10. It's kind of close to the delivery's kind of close to the bridge, so hopefully the one or two exits that are a mile before it are open. Google Maps shows them open usually if there's something closed. Hold on a second. Darn solicitors, I don't know what that's about, but I figured 2 hours early, since I was going to get there an hour early anyways, an hour before that if they could take me in, that's just an hour earlier I get. But yeah, Google doesn't show any road closures there. Doesn't mean there's not. But I just got to remember, if he gives me a pickup, if it's across on the other side of the bridge, I'm going to have to backtrack around the 474 and then go up and around and come back down. So we shall see if tomorrow's delivery is going to be interesting or not. I'm sure the load I get tomorrow will cover me through the weekend. I'll get all these videos edited and post it online. Remember, if you can, like, subscribe, leave a comment. Yay, nay, just, you know, and give me some hints. If you're used to watching YouTube videos, I'm always waiting for somebody to, like, give me a tip on, yeah, you should make them longer, show more road footage, or more of talking ahead. Give me a comment. Let me know how I can improve. Reason I do this is, A, to practice my personal skills, and B, to, sometimes it's nice to be able to unload when you have a bad day and you don't have to worry about offending somebody on the other end while you're talking to them like a fleet manager. Well, y'all have a good day, and we'll see you in a little bit when we get rolling. Let's get out of here. It always helps when you put it in gear. There's some wood noise for a little bit. Once we get rolling on the highway, we'll roll up the windows. eastbound ramp calls down here.
Turn right at the traffic light, then take the first left.
They were saying they were building some kind of barbecue bar or some kind of bar upstairs. They're expanding their store, which was always on the small side anyways. Redoing the restaurant. A few other things, so... supposed to be done by December. Oh, now I can see why. Up on the road, like we don't already have issues with running around over crap that screws up our tires anyways. Yeah, now I can see why they rerouted you east the other way, because it used to be you came right out and you just stayed to the right and it went right back going on 94 east. They're going to do to this road afterwards. Wonder if they're going to change it that it's all right-hand exit. You'll go on 94 east or go straight and then go up on 94 west from the right too. Signs for that the westbound was closed, so I'm assuming you go straight and it broke down a side street to get on 94 west. They didn't say there was no 94 west detour. Well, ain't this special?
Plan. continue on I-41.
This way you're guaranteed a spot. And I want it's worth the $20. Alright, I'm loaded, so let's get out of here. Hey everyone. Well, we're about 13 miles from the Loves. And, let's see if he got it, because he put it through. That's kind of, he was working on a load, pulling cans again out of Burlington, going back to just north of Madison, delivering Saturday. So after I deliver in East Peoria, I would just head to Burlington, pick up cans, and then head towards Madison, deliver them Saturday morning, and then just pick where I'm gonna sit for the weekend. And then Monday he'll just buy me a load out of there. Said it was 300 miles total, even with the deadhead. Or no, 400 miles total with the deadhead. It was gonna pay. It's paying $1,200, so it pays $3 a mile. That'd bring me to a really good week. A really good week. Probably the best week I've ever had here. So I was teasing him. I go, well, you know, it's starting out fresh on Monday. You're gonna have to really work hard next week to come close to this. Starting out fresh. And he just laughs. So hopefully, you know, even if he can do a $5,000 week next week, I mean, it's kind of, I'm kind of caught in the empty can cycle. You know, I take empty cans out of either location to somewhere up there and then grab something else. That's nice, because like I said, this thing's only 20,000 pounds. My fuel mileage is excellent.
Make a U-turn.
so impatient behind me. He's got to race to find a spot. There's a thousand spots here. And he wants to play race car driver. Oops, cut that one a little sharp. Oops. You didn't see that. That was being stupid.